Welcome to the joint service of St. Thomas United Church and Foothills United Church as we gather here this morning for worship. Each Sunday, we acknowledge that we are on Treaty 7 land, the traditional territory of the Kainai, Piikani, Siksika, and Stoney Nakoda and Tsuut'ina nations, and also including the Region 3 Métis Nation. In acknowledging this land, we call ourselves to live with respect in creation and in right relationship with all its peoples. We understand that this means structural and personal change. We also light the Christ candle this morning. Acknowledging Christ's light here with us in worship. And now let us join together with more voices, number 92, Like a Rock.
Like a rock, like a rock, God is under our feet. Like the starry night sky, God is over our head. Like the sun on the horizon, God is ever before. Like the river runs to ocean, like a rock, God is under our feet. Like the starry night sky, God is over our head. Like the sun on the horizon, God is ever before. Like the river runs to ocean, our home is in God evermore.
And now let us join together in our call to worship. Your part is in yellow. Gather in community and in trust, trusting God's place in our lives and in the space between us, uniting us together as one people and united us with God's presence. Together, let us gather in prayer and in praise as God's own people. Amen. And now let us join together in unison in our opening prayer. Holy God, we see you at work in our lives in the small ways we strain to notice, and in the marvelous ways your work is made known. Help us to trust in you as we live out our lives, helping us to act according to the freedom you have gifted us, to think, to dream, and to overcome, trusting that you are with us, yearning for good things even amidst the challenges of the world. Help us to see your place, to acknowledge the struggles, and to trust that you are with us, for we are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen. And now let's join together in the hymn, Voices United 642, Be Thou My Vision.
Be Thou My Vision, O joy of my heart. Not be all else to me, save that Thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night. Waking or sleeping, my light. Be thou my wisdom, my calm in all strife. I ever with thee, and thou me
Good morning. The scripture this morning is taken from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30, verses 1 to 5. When all these things have happened to you, the blessings and the curses that I have set before you, if you call them to mind among all the nations where the Lord your God has driven you, and return to the Lord your God, and you and your children obey him with all your heart, with all your soul, just as I am commanding you today, then the Lord your God will restore your fortunes and have compassion on you, gathering you again from all the peoples among whom the Lord your God has scattered you. Even if you are exiled to the ends of the world, from there the Lord your God will gather you, and from there he will bring you back. The Lord your God will bring you into the land that your ancestors possessed, and you will possess it. He will make you more prosperous and numerous than your ancestors. This is the witness of the church. Thanks be to God.
Today we end our summer series of things you thought were in the Bible but aren't. There are some whose answer to the question, does everything happen for a reason, is definitely no. They say it's bad philosophy, bad theology, bad thinking, and bad advice. Others say that while God certainly gives our lives meaning, the idea that everything we suffer, all the horrible experiences we've endured, have a purpose and meaning is actually harmful to our spiritual walk. And I have to admit, that's one of my main problems with this saying, too. Now, the yes people who express the opinion that everything does happen for a reason are often hoping what they say will comfort and console those going through seemingly senseless suffering. For me, the problem with the saying everything happens for a reason is that it assumes that the everything we're experiencing has been planned and orchestrated or micromanaged by God. To me, that's dangerous territory and can lead to a crisis of faith. Sometimes stuff just happens. I believe to my core that none of those involved God or Jesus at the wheel. The divine one in our lives doesn't create any of these circumstances, and that's why I have a problem with the saying, everything happens for a reason. And the saying isn't in the Bible. But our scripture passage this morning from Deuteronomy 30 subverts the reason things happen to being about restoration and healing. The Israelite exile and the struggles Moses had with his people, who understandably were all over the place in their faith because they were consistently being challenged with obstacles in their path. The hits just kept coming. They felt cursed. And this chapter contemplates the possibility of a restoration still to come. The passage says, if you call those obstacles to mind, God will restore your fortunes. In other words, an awakening among the people themselves must precede their restoration. This passage is to be a reminder to us all that despite the struggles and hardships, God not only is with us through all those hard times, but that God will bring about restoration. Writer, poet, and blogger Jeanette Navalon wrote an article on ideapod.com that I love, and it challenges us to reclaim the saying, everything happens for a reason, by redefining the word reason. She suggests that if we move from reason, meaning cause and effect in a systematic universe where events are random, to reason, meaning the meaning we give to the events that happen in our lives, then the saying becomes what I believe people are intending it to be, supportive and nurturing and encouraging. Navalon says that the events we're going through and the actions we are creating, that we take, are creating the person we're becoming. So when we link that back to our scripture of Deuteronomy, it's not about the struggles and hardships being of God. It's about how we respond to those struggles and hardships that are of God. And that becomes our reason. Navalon says that we are not some random element in the universe reaching or reacting mechanically to everything happening to us. Instead, we are human beings, and we have been gifted with the capacity and the power to create meaning from all these events and start making life work for us rather than against us. Navalon's article goes on to say that there are 7 things that help us find meaning to the events that happen in our lives. 7 responses we can have. I've adapted them for us in a Christian setting by saying that there are 7 opportunities for God to journey with us and restore us from the struggles and sorrows of life. And don't we all need restoration throughout our lives? For the purpose of illustrating these 7 steps of restoration, I'm going to use a personal example of a time of trial for our family. And this time of trial is about an RV camper, and we're naming it Vingalot. The first step to restoration, of course, is the opportunity for growth from tragedy to adversity. It's about perseverance, not defeat. Vingalot was a tragedy right from the get-go. About 10 years ago, we were gifted this camper from Todd's mom and dad. We were thrilled. So we drove out to Manitoba to pick it up from Uncle Harley's and Auntie Vivian's farm. If the weather was any indication of things to come, we should have seen this tragedy coming miles away. Had we abandoned the whole idea when Vingalot the camper wouldn't start, we would have avoided this tyranny. So it went to a mechanic for a day. It finally started. We drove it home, stopping in Saskatchewan overnight. It was lovely. Took it to our mechanic for a provincial inspection, and that wasn't so lovely. Mechanic was surprised that we weren't killed coming home on those tires or severely maimed with the other mechanical concerns. We spent thousands of dollars. We went camping. It was lovely. Furnace didn't work. Less lovely. Toilet leaked, but that's okay. We bought some parts. It stopped leaking, only to start again. The gas tank is empty already? The second gas tank is empty already? Do we have a third gas tank? No? Sigh. We drove it to BC to visit Todd's mom and dad. We filled the tank in Calgary. We had to stop in Canmore and fill the tank again. And so it continued to McBride, BC. We weren't sure we could make it to the next gas station. So we bought jerry cans and filled them both with gas. We needed them both. Got to Todd's mom and dad's in BC. It was lovely. Forest fires came. Very, very unlovely. We helped evacuate animals, farm animals. We evacuated ourselves. We drove home, stopping often for gas. We stayed in Wapiti Campground as our last overnight. It was lovely. We left early in the morning. It was raining. The wiper flew off. The last unlovely thing we could manage. Todd silently shaking his head. We then parked Vingalot at my mom and dad's farm. We were done with Vingalot the camper. Todd's mom and dad came a couple of years later to reclaim it. They came from BC in the middle of the night to pick it up. They drove it home. It caught fire on the way home. They parked it on their farm, never to be driven again. We were happy Vingalot was no longer ours. Our tragedy of hit after hit has become an amusing story of perseverance. The second step to restoration is looking at facing challenges as being an opportunity for closure. If we can accept the reality and finality of a situation, we're able to rewrite the story, which allows us to let that helpless situation go and move on to better things ahead. We felt helpless with Vingalot the camper, and its many problems and the thousands of dollars we spent while we had it. But when we finally decided to let it go metaphorically and not let it roll down the mountain like we first considered, our burdens were lifted. The third step to restoration is the opportunity to alleviate our pain. The Vingalot camper adventure was a sore point for us, and we beat ourselves up for having spent so much time and money. But I have no doubt that God was with us, giggling with us in the background with the sheer ridiculousness of the situation, punctuated with the loss of our wiper at the end, and that helped us gain a better sense of humor in the face of adversity. The fourth step to restoration is the opportunity to reflect. Navalon writes, "By choosing to believe that everything in our life has a bigger meaning, you allow yourself to the openness to see the picture not as it is right now, but as it could be when all the pieces finally are put together. One day," she says, "all the pain, struggles, setbacks, and doubting makes sense." When reflecting on our Vingalot camper escapades, all I need to say now is that I have a sermon. The fifth step to restoration is the opportunity for being led to the defining moments in our lives, those aha moments that only come after hardship and struggle, and we've had a chance to reflect, look back, and gain an awareness that we didn't have to begin with. If there's a eureka moment in the Vingalot the camper foibles, it would be an awareness that we are much more patient than we should be. And there are a lot of places that sell wiper blades. The sixth step to restoration is the opportunity to make sense of the chaos in our lives. The chaos we lived through with Vingalot the camper was demoralizing in the moment. But our response to it being laughter helped us remoralize the silver lining of experiencing this ridiculous chaos together with light hearts. And lastly, the seventh step towards restoration is the opportunity to learn valuable lessons. Facing hardships and struggle head-on often shatters our old beliefs, literally changing us to a better version of ourselves. Never did we ever think we would have gone through such a comedy of errors with Vingalot the camper. We faced it head on, persevered, and realized that having this particular camper compared to every other camper was an unexpected challenge, to be sure. But it brought lots of laughter and a great story. Restoration and healing always come with lessons and learning. So when reflecting on the saying, "everything happens for a reason," we can remember today's scripture from Deuteronomy and be assured that God is a God of restoration, not a God of breaking down. And that in every negative circumstance, we have a choice to either become unresponsive and stop learning, or to journey with God through the pain and struggle and see the many opportunities that can come from those hardships. By responding the way we did to our Vingalot the camper fiasco, it empowered us to create a hilarious anecdote to share for years and years to come. Let's reframe the saying, "everything happens for a reason," and do so using the definition of reason being the meaning we give to the events that happen in our lives. I know that my example was lighthearted, but I guarantee you that even in the hardest and darkest of times and situations, we can create meaning to bolster the faith in ourselves and the capacity of what we're able to do and endure. And let us remember that through every struggle and sorrow, every hardship and grief, through it all, we never journey alone. Thanks be to God, who doesn't hand us those tragedies and setbacks or Vingalots, but who journeys with us always, helping us to be restored once again. Amen.
1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4.
You
skip around in circles, you lost track. A heavy load feels like a monkey on your back. Don't you worry, pretty baby, honey child, don't you mourn. When the dark night is over, there's gonna be a brand new dawn. No motivation, disintegration. You lost your sense of destination. Don't you worry, pretty baby, honey child, don't you mourn. When the dark night is over, there's gonna be a brand new dawn. What goes up must come down. This old world keeps spinning round. Nobody knows the day till the evening sun goes down. Your money all gone. Friends, you got none. Don't you worry, pretty baby, honey child, don't you mourn. When the dark night is over, there's gonna be a brand new dawn. Don't you worry, pretty baby, honey child, don't you mourn. When the dark night is over, there's gonna be a brand new dawn. There's gonna be a brand new dawn.
At this time, we recognize the gifts of God's people that enable the work of the church both in our community and in our world. We celebrate the giving of treasure, but also acknowledge the gifts of time and talent shared in community. We give thanks for all those that continue to support the work of the church through your continued support by mailing in donations to both St. Thomas and Foothills United, and by those participating in our pre-authorized remittance program. I'd invite anyone who wants to continue their support to donate now through our Donate Now button on the website. In thanksgiving, let us gather in prayer. Let us pray. Holy One, may the gifts of our living, the outpouring of our hearts, and the service of our hands be sign and symbol of your place in our midst. Help us to support and overcome the struggles of this world in our lives and in this place. May these things we offer be used to enable your mission and ministry, now and always. Amen. Our call to prayer this morning, More Voices, number 7, Gather Us In. Let us gather our hearts in song. Let us gather our hearts in a time of prayer. Let us pray. Holy God, as we gather our hearts and still our minds in a time of prayer, we pause to recognize your presence in this place, your presence in our lives, and your presence in our midst. We give thanks that we are not alone, that you continue to be with us, even when we cannot see you, when we strain to feel you, or when we fail to notice your ways. In the moments when we feel most separated, O God, help us to trust, to reach out in prayer and hold out hope that you have promised to be with us always. Gather us in this time and in your midst, that together in community and in prayer, your place might be made known in our lives. Holy God, we pray for one another. We pray for those impacted by the strains and stresses of this time, for those that have lost lives, loved ones, careers, security, and peace of mind. We pray for all those that continue to support, to care, and work towards the healing of us all through these challenging times. Oh God, we pray for all those returning for another year, for those returning to work, to school, to teaching, and to learning, for those in classrooms and in workrooms, at schools and at home, online and in person. We pray for open hands, open hearts, and open minds. We pray for the health and healing, for safety and discerning. We ask that you would be with us all in these uncertain times. Holy One, we pray for all those on our hearts and in our minds and in our community, as we pray for all those with health issues and concerns, for those with diagnoses looming, and for unanswered questions, for those with uphill battles and long roads ahead. We pray for all those feeling as if life is spinning out of control, racing too quickly, or stuck on repeat. We hold one another in the care of community and prayer, in the trust of your presence and the love you have taught us to share with one another. Be with us as we uphold each other. Give us the strength to support one another and to receive support in times of need. Help us to offer and accept the love that you offer, the love of others, knowing in each moment you are there with us. Holy One, be with us as we lift up the prayers of your people, of our own hearts, and of one another, as we lift up our prayers in a time of silence. Holy God, we gather these and all our prayers, spoken aloud and held in the silence of our hearts, as we continue praying by singing together the Lord's Prayer. Let us sing.
Thank you.
Please join with me as we enter into a time of our commissioning. Your part is in yellow. For together with God, we are not alone. For together as community, we are not alone. As we leave this time to go out into the world once more, we are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen. And so may the Creator in whose image we have all been created, the Son Jesus who grew in wisdom and modeled inclusion, and the Holy Spirit who leads and guides us towards justice and compassion be with us now and evermore. Amen.
To the sound.